Hey guys, Joe the mechanic. Today we're going to be replacing the bearings in the casters on the front of your zero-turn lawnmower. And the one we're going to be doing it on is the Gravely ZTX42. Let me get the camera turned around and I'll show you what we're going to be doing.
Spark plugs, oil grease, horsepower, more speed, big blocks and transmissions. That's the best things that's happened to men since women.
Okay, the bearings we're going to be replacing today are the ones under this cap and in here. Now, the problem with ours is when you go over an uneven ground and one wheel comes up, it kind of makes like a clicking sound, and we've been trying to figure out what it is. But if that's not the case for you, you just need to replace them, then I'm going to show you how. The first thing I'm going to do is take these tires off because it's just one bolt, and it's going to make it a lot easier to access everything else that we have to do. I'm also going to jack the front of the mower up here and put jack stands under here. If you don't have jack stands or a jack, it's no big deal, but I feel it's going to make it easier to get the weight off of it. And I'm not going under it, so you don't need jack stands, but to not have the big handle of the jack coming out here, it's going to make it easier, so I'm just going to throw a jack stand under each corner. So let me get the tripod set up and we'll jack it up and take those tires off. Repeat the same process on the other side. Alright guys, so we're going to have to take these covers off. Now you're going to want to use a small flat head and put it under your cap there on the edge and give the back of it a small tap with a hammer and it should pop the seal, and you're just going to go around. Now don't do too much of that prying action because it's going to scratch your paint off, and you don't want to hit the hammer too hard because it could put dents in this and you could also break your screwdriver handle. Now, if you have a ball peen hammer, I suggest just taking the round end and giving it a little tap around the edge to maybe, if it's rusted on, you could knock it loose a little. All right, so we'll come in here. Step up to a bigger screwdriver and that should knock it right off like that. Now we bring the camera up here, we have a bolt and we're gonna have to remove that. Now you can see that moves with your wheel here, so you're gonna have to put a screwdriver in here as such and have somebody hold the screwdriver. You can try and hold it, or you can even put the bolt back through and loosen that. Now if you really want to make it easy for yourself, or maybe there's just you can lower it back down on the ground with the tires on and it'll be harder for them to move on the ground. But we got to get that bolt removed, and everything I'm doing on this side, I'm going to show you everything on this side. All you have to do is repeat it the exact same way on the other side. I'm not going to show the other side, I'm just going to show this side. So let's get the right size socket and take that bolt out. Alrighty guys, now I'm going to be using my impact again, so I don't really have to hold this all that much, because instead of using torque, it's using the impact. So, and you can see that blast right off and comes right out. So now repeat that on the other side and I'll get back to you on how to get the bearings out. Alrighty, so now when you take these bolts off, this thing's supposed to fall out. If it doesn't fall out, and now I'm thinking to myself, one of them, that side fell right out, and I told you I had that clicking problem. So this could be some of my problem here. This one's seized up. Now, if it doesn't want to come out, instead of banging on this with a hammer, that's your bearing there. And if you put a Phillips head screwdriver in there, or a awl or something like that, and beat it, you can mess up your threads. So what you want to do is take your bolt, thread it back. Okay, a little bit more difficult than possible. All right, well, I'm one-handed here. So thread it into your hole. And then instead of that, you want to thread it in, I don't know, about an inch, 3/4 to an inch, and just tap on the bolt and it'll knock it out. And you're hitting the bolt instead of messing up your threads or your bearings. So thread it in and tap it if they don't fall out. That's the other side fell out with these. This one's a little locked up. All right, so let me get bolt these off and then we'll go to the bearings. All right, guys, so to get these bearings out, what you're gonna wanna do is take a bolt, or in my case, I'm gonna use an impact extension, put it down in the hole till you hit that other bearing. Now, don't worry about busting it up because we're replacing them. But I suggest doing the bottom one first because it's easier to get the top one up. Now, they're sitting on a little shelf so that make sure they don't go up, or that the bottom one doesn't go up. And the top one doesn't go down. So that the bottom one has to go down and out, and the top one has to go up and out. So the impact extension is sitting on that bearing, and we're gonna beat it with the hammer until it pops out, and we're just gonna go around the inside of that bearing and knock it out. So let me put the tripod back up, and you can watch me blast that out. I suggest using a sledgehammer for this, because it takes a long time. Was the easy one. Getting the top one out is kind of a pain in the ass. So now I got a socket. I'm gonna put it right here until it hits this thing and try this now. Alrighty, guys, so now you just want to take your rag and clean out all the grease and crap that's been building up from where this bearing sits, top and bottom, and then just give the inside a little clean out too. But basically you want to make sure it's clean where your bearing sits, and down there on that shelf, we'll make sure that's cleaned off too. That way, you know, it's not really much of a big deal, but if you got some sediment on that shelf, it'll actually hold up one side of the bearing higher than the other. So just make sure it's nice and clean, so when we're ready to insert the new ones, we have nothing in our way from just tapping it right down onto that shelf. And if you finish the video here and you figure I'm gonna tap them in myself, I know how to finish it off. Just make sure that you don't hit that bearing in with something with a very high force or something metal, because you can bust those bearings. The ones we busted out, if you bust them up, you know, they're garbage anyway. The new ones, you don't want to break them, because then, you know, it's pretty much pointless. So I will see you when we insert the new ones. Alrighty, guys, so to insert the bearing, we're gonna first start with the top one. We can get it pretty much lined up. We're gonna take a small rubber mallet. See, we got it started, and then what we're gonna do is take this 36 millimeter socket, place it right there. You're gonna take this piece of bar stock or anything you can use to put on a surface there, So you have something to put your C-clamp on, which is going to rest on that. The one side of there, actually. And then you're going to push that on. Now I'm going to put you on time lapse, and you can watch me do this. Tells me I'm all the way in, but if you don't have Craftsman sockets, it just happens to be that the line on the Craftsman socket lines up. But you'll know because it'll be hard to turn, and then all of a sudden it'll be impossible to turn, and that's how you know you're all the way there. Get that out of there, that off of there, check that, looks good. And if we feel under here, we cannot feel a gap between the bearing and the shelf. So now it's time to put our bottom one on and get our second bearing. Here's my second bearing. We can do the same thing and put a little WD-40 down in there. We can do it from the top even. And seeing that it's upside down, it's going to be a little harder to do that. So we can put some on the outside of the bearing. And start it the same way, try to make sure it's level. And then take a small rubber mallet. Your fork here, you want to take a rag and clean this off. Okay? And then take your, there's a washer down here. Pull that off, put it aside, and clean this shaft. Make sure everything's off the bottom there. Then, your washer here, and just, you know, just make sure there's nothing big on it. You don't have to take a wire brush to it or anything. Slide that on there, back on your shaft. Then take WD-40 and just go up and down the shaft, and make sure it's all around. Go ahead and slide your shaft on up all the way through. You should probably put your washers together before you start. Alright. Start threading that in there. That's the wrong size, isn't it? Shoot. It is. So just thread this down till it's close to tight, and then I'll see you for the next step. Alrighty guys, so the next step is going to be to put your tires back on. When the tires are on, we can lower it to the ground and tighten this down a little bit more because it'll be easier to hold it from moving. So just slide your carriage bolt back through with your tire. If you never took the tire off, don't worry about it. But just put your tire back on, put your carriage bolt through, tighten the bolt up, and then you lift it up off your jack stands, or just let your jack down depending on what you're doing. And then once it's on the ground, I'll bring the camera back and I'll show you tightening these. Alrighty guys, for your last step today, you're gonna wanna take your cap, Place it on top there, slightly even. Done. And repeat this whole process on the other side, and then tap that cap on as well. So there you go, you finished replacing your bearings. Now, take these things to a little test drive and work those bearings in. And once you come back from that test drive, come over here and pop your cap off again, you know, the same way we did before. And pack some grease on top of those bearings and maybe underneath if you can. I wouldn't take it back apart, but if you want to, you can. But just get some grease around there. It's all moving in there. So it's good to get some grease in there. Other than that, that about wraps up this video. So take it for a test drive, and thanks for watching. I will see you on the next video. If you like this video, please give it a like. If you have any questions, please leave them in the comments. And if you want to know the part number, leave it in the comments, and I will put it in the comments for you. And that's basically it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you on the next one. Remember to subscribe, and have a nice day.